Now, ANC have confirmed that the day has been set for Jacob Zuma's case within the ANC. It will be then decided whether or not they decide to terminate his membership, which is actually exactly what I think previously. Those are some of the sentiments that they shared. But it's not that I am, you know what I'm saying? Not that I'm interested of that, but I'm going to tell you what MK is going to do with this one. It's going to be nice. Now, in a confirmation letter, it has been written, African National Congress, National Disciplinary Committee, NDC, Office of the Chair, Office of the Chairperson, is it Comrade Ralph Maloko? I can't say that one. Now, this is the case number in a matter between African National Congress complainant and Jacob Zuma charged member. Case number 1/2024. I can tell you that MK is going to make the most out of this. MK is going to make the most out of this and they will regret. Believe you me, MK is going to make the most out of this. You'll remember that when they wanted to charge MK previously, MK said, "Ah, you want to charge Zuma? Bring it on." And then MK said, "Okay, so you are taking us to Luthuli House. We'll make the most of it. We'll." So I am already sure that there is a way that they found that they're going to make sure that they shine on a day. On that day, chances are, The streets around Luthuli House will be closed. Believe it or not, MK is prepared for that. Well, we're also prepared for this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, as we proceed, let's look at this. Take notice that the disciplinary hearing of the charged member will take place on virtual platform as follows. Again, they refuse to go to Luthuli House. So, why? Because they know that the brand, Jacob Zuma, is going to swallow their brand. So they say it's going to take place virtually. Okay, I did not read the letter before, guys. That's why I said what I said previously. But nevertheless, even then, who's going to be allowed to join and who will not be allowed to join? It's a question that I want to ask. Who's going to be allowed to join and who will not be allowed to join? The date for this is going to be Wednesday, 17 July, 2024. Let me repeat the date. The date for the hearing between Jacob Zuma, charged member, and the ANC complainant is going to be 17 July 2024. It will be on Wednesday. Time is going to be 10 o'clock. Now they say, log in details will be sent to all parties closer to the date of hearing. Dated at Johannesburg this first day of July 2024. So that's the date in which they released that. Now, I do acknowledge the fact that Fikile Mbalula did say that they are intending to deal with this after the elections. And for sure, they did not disappoint in that they stuck to their promise. However, I can almost guarantee you that this conversation is going to be leaked. So I don't know whether it's their pursue, they want it that way. You can't have this conversation online. You can't. Like, really, guys, you can't. You can't have a conversation of such magnitude online. You can't. You really cannot do that. But the NC have decided that. These online platforms, guys, has proven to be difficult. They are not efficient. They are not fluent. Number two, it doesn't make sense. Remember that we did spoke about this previously, that it doesn't make sense. Important meetings are to be held physically. It's always important if you want to have the most important information, it is always important to have those meetings physically. Let me repeat this one. It is always important to have all important meetings physically. It is always important to avoid anything. I don't understand if the DA, like the ANC, doesn't learn from its negotiations with the DA. Why am I saying that? Or why am I bringing that into the fore? Because what we learn from what we have learned from the negotiations is that these two parties, because they were negotiating through letters, it ended up being a matter of a public spectacle. One who disagreed with this leaked the letter, and vice versa. We happens to get info between the two parties. And if they had done that in a manner that it is well protected, nothing get leaked, then the conversation between the ANC and the DA, or the negotiations, would have been better handled. So I'm saying that to say, it doesn't make sense from my perspective. It doesn't make any logical sense, zero whatsoever, to have this thing virtually. On the other hand, to me, it sounds degrading. It's not like Jacob Zuma is in America, somewhere in Russia, China. He's here. You just arrange. It's either you go to him or he comes to you. Then you have the meeting. And then in that way, it doesn't make sense anyway. But the NC has decided anyway. So because they've decided, maybe it's their way of maybe finding ways that just saying we are not that important. Another thing that is also concerning as well is that Zuma did indicate Ogoti, there are people within the very same ANC who went out to support other political parties. What has happened to them? So I'm interested, because that's another interesting argument that Zuma brought. Why am I bringing that? Is because we all know Ogoti, or rumor has it that a person who even wrote a constitution year cop, it is Umbeki himself. Well, leave that argument alone. It holds water. And then you say, during Zuma's tenure, there are people who voted with the enemy. Nothing has happened to them. Because if the ANC says you cannot be a member of the ANC and support another political party, then it must justify all of those things. That what happened to the people who were seen live, who took that bold decision to vote against Zuma during his time by voting with the enemies? What happened to them? Right? Nothing happens to them. Why? Why now it becomes a problem when Zuma says, I am your member, but I'm not going to vote for you? Why is it becoming a problem now? I'm sure we're going to hear a long list of people who voted with the enemy and not against the ANC, but the ANC have never done anything to them. And that's where we will see that the ANC is being personal against Jacob Zuma.